and welcome to Facebook Live here at the Joann headquarters. Today we're going to be talking about some holiday decorating for your home, and we're going to be crafting some holiday projects as well. Right now is an amazing time to get in store because we have our front of store holiday seasonal product on sale at 60% off. 60%, that's huge, so it's a great time to get in store, buy some stuff before the week gets super busy for the holidays, and start decorating. So today I'm going to show you how to decorate a mantelscape. It's very simple logic, but we're going to go through it together to make it even easier. What I like to do when it comes to the mantel is basically wipe everything on my mantel off the mantel and start fresh for the season. So currently I have a bunch of projects on there, I have mirrors on there. We're gonna take them off of there and we're gonna start with some greenery. So you can see behind me, I have a beautiful garland swag. This is just from store. I didn't even craft anything onto this and it's already perfectly placed with some pine cones and some berries. It adds a little color to the mantel. We have a variety of different garlands in store as well. So whatever your styling, decor, colors are, or your look is, we have something for you. So I start with laying it across the mantel. Then as you can see, I have a center focal piece. This again is another seasonal piece that we have at front of store. We have a variety, we have endless choices. Actually, it was kind of hard to decide what I was gonna do for today. And so I went ahead and put that center of the mantel. I liked to frame that with the two bells that you also see next to it. These are real bells that are awesome. So I would definitely get in store and get one, whether it be for your mantel or for maybe your door outside. They ring and they're beautiful. They're awesome. So go ahead and grab one of those while you're in the store as well. Now let's decorate it. The idea is to keep everything symmetrical. It'll help keep your eye focused to the center when you initially look at the mantle, but then it'll graze around as you continue to look and all your guests can check out what you have. So first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna start in the center with my candles. These candles, we have a few different colors that we sell in store, and these are LED, so they're super safe. It's a great way to add some flicker to the mantle without any safety hazards. So I'm gonna go ahead and put these right in the center. You can kind of scatter them a little. As you can see, I put one behind the garland. I put one in front of the garland. That gives a nice depth to the mantle. Now I'm gonna go ahead and actually change them out. This one's the taller one, so I'm gonna put this one center. Next, I'm going to add a couple pieces. So we have a variety of signs in store that we're selling right now. So depending on what your theme is or what you want to portray on your mantle, we have something for you. I have this Be Merry one that I'm going to put up there today to go with my color scape. So now I'm starting to work from the outside in. This side is in balance, so I'm going to put something over there now. I have this awesome nutcracker guy. Again, we have a variety of colors and styles and ideas. So I'm gonna go ahead and put this over here. And I'm gonna put him towards the back just so that he's nice and safe in the back corner. Next up, you have two things here. I'm gonna show you how to start crafting these. This one is actually a wood slab that we sell that we did a photo transfer on. Photo transfer is a really cool technique for yourself or to give as a gift because you can do this on a variety of surfaces, whether it be wood, canvas, fabrics, tote bags, even candles. You can do it on a variety of surfaces. So this one we did on the wood, but I'm gonna show you how to do it as well. I'm gonna go ahead and put this on my mantle right now though since I have it. And then the tree. So this is one of our unfinished trees. We have a variety of shapes that I'm gonna go through today. But this guy, I'm just gonna go ahead and put up for placement and then I'm gonna show you how you can craft it in different ways. Now looking at my mantle, I'm gonna change things up just a little bit. Excuse my back. I'm gonna move him over, put that there, and as we start crafting the other trees, you'll see it all come together. The first tree that I'm gonna go ahead and craft is the photo transfer, so we can get right to it and I can show you how it works. I have a variety of different Mod Podges with me today that do a variety of different things. So we're gonna go through that to better explain what all the different ones are so when you're in that aisle looking, you know what you're looking for. You're gonna go ahead and take your wood base. So this beautiful triangle tree is what I'm gonna start with. I'm going to use it actually as my template to go ahead and trace my picture. Oh, there's my Sharpie. I knew I had it on here somewhere. Go ahead and trace it out. It's a triangle, so I'm just gonna go ahead. I know that shape easily. It's easy to cut. So I have my triangle on there, and I'm just gonna go ahead and cut out this picture. This is a great idea. So I, at home, I have a lot of picture frames on my mantle, and this is awesome because I'm gonna take those off for the holiday, and I can replace it with my photo transfer. So I still have a family photo on the mantle. That means something to me. It's a great conversation piece, but now it also fits in with my holiday decor. So I have my triangle here. I'm just gonna trim off the white. So depending on the size that you're working on, it's okay if there's a little extra wood on the top and the bottom. It doesn't have to fit to the piece just right because you're gonna get a nice rough edge around the picture anyway, so it'll make it look a little more antique. So it's perfect. Then you're going to go ahead and you're going to take your photo transfer Mod Podge and you're going to put it on the face of your picture. After you put it on, you're going to put it right onto your wood surface. You really want to, you really want to put like a nice medium coat on there so it saturates well. And you put it all over. You're gonna put it onto your wood surface and you're actually gonna let it marinate for 24 hours. So you wanna give yourself time with this. This is definitely not a rush project. That's really just so that the picture transfers really well onto the surface that you're working on. I figured it's better to give it more time than not enough time just to make sure you really don't end up with a poor result. And to note, this printout is just normal printer paper. It's not anything fancy, so you can print it on any printer. Come on, buddy, there we go. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and just spread this all out here. A nice, again, a medium coat is perfect. Not too thin, not too goopy. All right, we got the idea there. And then I'm gonna move it onto my wood surface. You're gonna pat it down so it really adheres to the wood. You don't have to do anything else past that at this point. So you don't have to put any on top. You actually don't want to do that. If any pops out of the side, use your hand to get rid of it because that glue will show once it dries. So you want to make sure that it's not there. So I have this at this point. I'm going to go ahead and put it to the side for 24 hours, let it do its thing, and then you're gonna end up with this result. So now I have one that I've put a nice hot rag on. You can do rag, you can do paper or a towel as you see here, which is coming in handy right now because I've glued all over my hands. And I let it saturate for a little bit before this. And then you just take, whether it be your nail or your finger, something gently, because you don't wanna rub the picture underneath, and you just rub off the paper layer. It's gonna go ahead and leave the picture underneath. This is such a beautiful picture. I love. This is of my coworker, Erin. I don't know if you tuned in yesterday to see her story. If not, check it out on Facebook. It's a really beautiful story about her and her family. But this is one of her wedding photos. And so I used it because I just love it. And it was perfect for the shape. And what a great mantelpiece for the holidays. I guess I'm going to have to gift this to her, huh? It'd be perfect. Okay, so as you can see, it comes off so easily. It's leaving this beautiful picture underneath. You can kind of just work at it a little bit until you have exactly what you want. You can even take sandpaper and rough up the edges if you want to give it a little antique look as well. And you just keep kind of going back and forth. Again, just be kind of gentle with the picture underneath so you don't tear a hole into it. But that is what you end up with, this cute tree. So it's a perfect holiday shape with a beautiful picture of you and your family member. So I'm gonna go ahead and put this on my mantelscape. The next tree I'm gonna show you is, I guess while I'm making a mess, I'm just gonna keep making a mess. I'm gonna paint a tree for you. So this is a marbling technique that we're gonna do. Pretty simple. Save that paper cloth because I'm probably going to need it. Okay, so this one, you can use any color paint that you want. It's an acrylic paint. I have my wood surface here. As you can see, I have something underneath because it will make a mess. Even a box is great because then you can just pitch the whole thing. I'm gonna start pouring some acrylic paint onto it. And this is really one that none will be the same ever unless you like videotape yourself and watch yourself back. But that's what I love about it. It's a one of a kind piece. It's really cool. So I'm gonna put a couple colors on here just to get us started. And then you can go ahead and you tilt it a bit, and this is where it gets super messy. So that's why you want that surface underneath. Let me just kind of tilt it a little bit. I'll bring it back to the camera here in 1 second. Tilt it this way. Make sure you wear an apron. Unlike me right now, I'm being very hesitant not to get this on my clothes. And it starts to just make this really cool painted piece. Then I'm going to take my white that I have here and I'm going to drizzle on top. Let's go. There we go. I'm just going to go the whole way through like a big line and take a paintbrush and just start kind of swirling it through to get a neat technique. Now, because this is so saturated, because we're just kind of gooping it on there, you're going to definitely want to set this to the side because it's going to take a little while to dry. But then once it dries, look how cool this is. I love it. Once it dries, you can then put a glossy Mod Podge on top to really keep it so it lasts years and years and years on end. So that's where this Mod Podge comes into play. This is super cool. Obviously, you'll want to do the whole tree. You can do as much as you want. You can change up the colors so it fits your home decor. This, I think, is really, really neat. I'm going to go ahead and move this to the side, though, just so that we can not make a super huge mess today. And I'm not going to put this one on the mantle right now, obviously, because it would drip all over the place. But as you see, I already put the other one, its partner, up on the mantle on the side so that it has a nice placement. All right, let's get this guy out of the way. Super cool, though. We'll have to show it to you later once it's all dry. Next up is glittering. Now, I have a really easy, kind of clean way to do glitter, which isn't always easy. So it's usually very messy, actually. In my house, we make a lot of messes, but not everybody likes to do that. So what we're going to use is a bag to glitter. So you have your tree. Look how cute this shape is. I just love this shape. I'm going to go ahead and put, I'm actually going to use this glossy one right now. And I'm going to go ahead and paint it on here anywhere that I want to have glitter. Man, I am making a lot of messes today. Messes, but memories, right? That's what I like to think. Okay. So I'm going to just glitter the top of this guy here. Some of the sides. I'm not going to do the base, though. That's going to make it easier for me to pull it out of the bag. So just, you know, for sake of time, so you're not watching me just glue, I'm going to go ahead and throw this in the bag now. But you'll want to go ahead and make sure that all the areas that you want to glitter are saturated with the Mod Podge. And the glitter is just going to adhere beautifully to this. Okay, so let me go ahead. Now I'm going to move this guy out of the way to get glue on my bag, which is not part of the step, just so you know. I'm going to take the lid off of my glitter, and we have a variety of beautiful colors. I'm using this red today because it's really going to make a nice impact. You'll be able to see it well, but we're going to throw it in here. I'm going to save some because I might need to add a little bit to it. I'm going to put my tree into the bag. I'm going to seal it. I am going to wipe this glue off a little bit just so when I shake it, it doesn't get all over the place. We're going to shake this guy. You see it coming to life when we try to turn it so you can get the glitter. Look at it just like adhering right to it. Oh my gosh, it's so gorgeous. That took me, what, a couple seconds, maybe a couple minutes? Because I was talking and gluing. Shake it off. And voila. Look at how amazing that tree is. I love it. It's so beautiful. Again, you can do it in any color. It's really saturated. You'll want to obviously paint every side that you want to get glitter on. But look at this. Mess-free besides the glue. That's my fault. That's not part of the glitter. And the glitter's always the really messy part. So I'm going to go ahead and put the tree on the mantle. We're going to put this guy kind of center because the glitter, I think, is a nice focal for your eye. Use my back again. There we go. And it really pulls those candles in, so it makes for a nice color combo. I have one more tree left. I'm gonna use it. This towel is really coming in handy. Definitely, you do your fabric transfer one first, and that'll be perfect for you. Okay, next is doing one more tree to show you another technique that you can do using the paper Mod Podge, and that is adhering paper to it. You can do fabric as well, if that's what you prefer. I picked out a nice green color plaid. The plaid will add a nice detail to my mantle that's not currently there. I'm gonna go ahead and trace that triangle again that I did just like the photo transfer. I'm gonna go ahead and cut it out. And then you just go ahead and you almost use the Mod Podge like a glue and you go ahead and you put it on your tree. Out of the way. Here we go. Now I don't have a protective surface, so I have to be super careful this time. Okay, there we go. Super simple. This one can be a light coat. It doesn't have to be, you just want to make sure you get all the wood, but it can be a nice light coat. Put your paper on, place it where you want it to be. And then you can put another coat over top just to really seal it in. And you're gonna wanna set this to the side to allow it to dry. I'm gonna go ahead and put it on the mantle right now just so we have it out of the way, but it'll add a nice coat to it to keep it in place. So you have a beautiful tree. And those Mod Podge lines will disappear. So we're gonna put, I have my one little triangle on that side, I'm gonna put my other triangle on this side, I'm gonna put it back here by the bell. Okay, so we've done our tree decor, a few different ways to use different Mod Podges. There's different mess levels there, so depending on what you wanna do. Some of those are kid friendly too, so it's a nice activity to do as a family to get ready for the holidays. Next up, I'm going to show you two ornaments that I think are really cute and clever for your tree decorating. Again, these are relatively kid-friendly as well. The first one I'm going to show you is on my Christmas tree right here. Let me go ahead and bring it over for you. It's adding this little tree into one of our clear bulbs and then adding some glitter to it. Simple steps that make a really pretty impact. I think this is so cute, personally. So we have these little trees that come in a pack. You can go ahead and put a dab of glue or a glue dot, which works really well, that's what I did, on the bottom, and then you'll take tweezers and just go ahead and drop them right into the top. If you want to use tweezers or prongs that are long enough to really place it, otherwise if you drop it in there, you might have to move it around a little bit, but once that glue dot hits the base, it's there. You can move it, but it won't move on its own. It sticks really well, which is awesome. So then you have your tree in here. To make it simple for you, you can take some paper, just kind of cut it into a little kind of funnel shape. Stick that funnel in the top. Again, as you can see, it's not super big, but it's gonna help me with my glitter, which actually I need my hands to open for a minute. Okay, so we're gonna pour our glitter in here. I'm gonna use the fat glitter that's in this container right here. I'm gonna show you, this is so great. You have fine glitter and wide glitter in here. I love that because we're gonna use both for this project. It really comes in handy and it gives a little different dimension to your project. So I'm gonna face this towards me for a minute just so I don't make a super mess. I'm gonna cover up the fine glitter with my finger, and it's okay if some fine gets in there too. Shake it in. There we go. I'd get it at the right angle there. And then as you can see, we have some glitter in there, so it makes for a nice snow base underneath your tree, and it kind of covers up that glue part on the bottom. And hides it. So now that I have that, I'm gonna put the lid back on, or the top to my ornament back on. And I wanna cover up this just metal part. This is great to do with any ornament you have. Even if you buy an ornament and you just wanna get rid of that silver part, you can go ahead and use some Mod Podge or any adhesive and go over the top of it. Kinda saturate it lightly. You can even saturate the top of this bulb a little bit. And you can go ahead and sprinkle. I'm gonna use this guy here. Cover up the wide part. Sprinkle it with the fine glitter, a little wide glitter too, right now. You know what, let's get smart here. Let me put the lid on. Live and learn from me, guys. There we go. Actually, I like the wide glitter on there too. It looks really pretty, and it brings your eye to both. It kind of makes it cohesive, which is good. And then you have this beautiful ornament. I just think this is so cute. It's so simple. Adults, kids, anybody can do this. You can even take a tacky glue or an Elmer's glue and write the year on it and glue, and then add your glitter on it like that as well. And then you're gonna want to take a ribbon and make a nice string for your tree. We have a lot of beautiful decorative ribbons in store that can match any project that you're doing. That's ornament one. Ornament two is really neat because it's taking the trend of string art, using our wood bases and creating a beautiful piece. So right here I have the start of a star. This is what it'll end up looking like. You take the tacks that we sell in store in our home deck area and you just hammer them right in. I'm gonna show you, I'm gonna hammer one time because it's kind of loud and nobody wants to hear that. But I wanna show you how easy it is to hammer it into the sky. Done. It's so easy. So you can do any shape that you want, and then you go ahead and do your string art. So you take a piece of embroidery floss, you tie a little loop, tie it twice here just to make sure it really knots. There we go. I'm gonna wrap it around one nail or tack. And then you start looping it. Now, because it's a star, I wanna make sure I loop it in the star shape. I can have fun with it afterwards, but this way. I get the shape down, that way I don't mess up my star, and then I can go ahead and get crazy with my string art after. Oops. talking and string art is clearly not one of my specialties. Here we go. Okay, so now I have my star shape, and then you can just kind of get crazy and go around and circle them around, and then when you get your last one, you just do the same thing. You tie a little knot at the end and keep it in place. But you can have a lot of fun with this. There's no real rhyme or reason to it. You just string around until you're done. You have a nice filled-in star, and then voila, it's done. You can do snowmen, you can do trees, you can do hearts, lots of different varieties, simple shapes that work so cute on this ornament. The last thing that I want to show you today for some fun holiday crafting is a throw. I wanted to throw this one into it, even though it's not a mantelscape and it's not a tablescape, because our Luxe Fleece is on sale this weekend at 50% off, which is so awesome. I know you can't feel this right now, but it is so soft and snuggly and wonderful. Luxe Fleece is so great. So you're going to want to go ahead and get some of this. Get some for you and for your friends, because as you're crafting gifts, you're going to want one for yourself. So I'm going to show you a few different treatments on how to make a no-sew blanket just using this fleece. No sewing, super easy. The first technique I'm going to show you is doing the knotted ends. Now this is as simple as, I already cut some in, but just simple as cutting strips about an inch long. I already have a few in here, so I'm just going to show you how I cut it like that, and then doing a knot. It's that simple. You don't have to do any special finishing treatments. Fleece doesn't fray. Done. So cute. So you have this nice, you'll start to get this nice knotted end with little fringes. Another really fun trick that I like doing is a scalloped edge. As you can see here, I already started my scalloped edge. To get the perfect scallop that's the same shape throughout the entire thing, I took a ribbon. Everybody has some holiday ribbon around the house, and if not, it's a great time to get in store and get some. And you use that as your template. How smart and clever is that? And you just kind of, there you go, you just kind of eyeball the placement. If you feel like you really want to make sure that you're doing it just right, you can make dots along or measure an inch in. And I just realized as I'm doing this live that I markered on the nice side. You want to definitely do the back side of your fleece in case you have a little marker that spills over or you just cut into that part. But that creates a really cute scalloped finish, which I just think is nice and feminine and pretty and super easy to do. The last end that you can do is a nice blanket stitch. Let me find my needle. I'm using an embroidery needle here, and I'm using yarn. Now, as I started this earlier, I realized the yarn in this embroidery needle uses a little muscle effort to get it in there, but it's definitely doable. So from the back side, you would just put the needle through. Pull it through is where you gotta use those muscles. Oops, let me get my ribbon out of the way. Pull it through. You could also use an embroidery floss too, which is thinner, but I liked the thicker one because it really pops well. There we go. Sorry about that, shouldn't be that hard. And then you're gonna wanna leave a little bit of the loop left once you pull it through, and you just put your needle through and pull, and that's what creates your blanket stitch. As you're going, you want to make sure that you kind of keep your stitches symmetrical, even, so it looks great. You can even dot the back with a fabric marker for your placement if that's easier for you as well, rather than just eyeballing it. But these are three really great treatments to make a no-sew blanket with a super soft, amazing fabric that you need to get in store and get right now because it's so great. I hope you enjoyed our Facebook Live today. Please comment, share, and like this. We can't wait to see what you're crafting as well.